Hey everyone, it's BTM-Kiwi back again with another Forza Horizon 5 ForzaThon. This week we need to own and drive the 2000 Nissan Silvia Spec R Aero. We then need to win a street race with it. We then need to earn 5 ultimate drift skills in it, and then we need to get 5 stars from speed from drift zones in it. Nice and simple. Daily, smash 5 phone booths, complete a Super 7, earn 5 drift skills at the top of La Gran Caldera. And then I did have to earn 200,000 drift points at drift zones in any vehicle from the 90s, which I did at the Hot Wheels site, which I did this one, and I did it in the Ford Escort. V8 swapped, and I did try streaming this earlier, but for some reason it didn't take, it didn't remember, and it wouldn't let me make progress on this. And I managed to get some progress completed. So I'm going to see if it will allow me to continue making progress. So, hopefully. In the ForzaThon shop, McLaren F1 GT. Grab that if you don't already have it. It is amazing. Well, it's really expensive, so it's good to get it this way. Wheel spins, 911 GT2. Got a trail like usual, a new event lab, and a speed zone and a trailblazer. And the three standard championships. We do have a treasure hunt this week, which is using the Ford Racing Puma 1999 and finishing a race, a circuit race, I believe. And then we just got our photo challenge, photographed the 1997 Mitsubishi GTO under the Arch of Maluji. Used to be one of my favorite cars back on the first Gran Turismo because it came in green and I loved the color green, so that's what was my go-to car. Got the Subaru Legacy RS, new exclusive car, not really new to this game, but it's been in the franchise in most of the games. And yeah, let's try and see if this will work. I so hope it does. This is gonna piss me off if it doesn't work again. Get away from here so that I don't get copyright strike by the music. Street race. Let's pray that this works. Doesn't say it needs to be stock standard, so hopefully that means it will work. catch that, what that said for that epilogue. I'm not happy with that. Please count towards progress. In the correct car. Cool, it counted, it just didn't pop up. Thank Frick for that. Ultimate drift skills. Surely that's enough. Yeah, cool. It's not telling me now. More bugs and glitches in the game, but at least it's working and actually making progress. That's good. This bank. To figure out which one it was. Could have been that one. It's V8. How's the other one? The rear wing's different. It's definitely this one. There we go. That's that done. The weekly. It's a pretty good drift build, that. Oh, I should have done that at the top of the Grand Cadera. Smash 5 phone booths is our trail. A class 1992-2009. I'll probably just have to go to the Ford that I used. I need 32 seconds remaining. All those little annoying. annoying ass rocks in the way that shouldn't even be there. And then shit like that. It was slowing me down. That done. I should try to smash 5 phone booths. Best place to do that. Oh look, there's our speed zone. Might as well do that. It's on dirt as well. I need 112.7 kilometers. Why didn't I mark it? Probably thought the car would have turned out of my way. But oh well, we got it done. Right, now where's the main street through here, and let's try and get some phone booths. I just need to find one, and I just need to smash into it about 100 kilometers an hour, and then just keep rewinding and going into it.
At the roundabout, take the second exit.
Because that counts as 2 and 1 because they're back to back. Rewinding works wonders. Alright, let's take that photo. And then we need to do a race in the Ford Racing Puma. Circuit race, I believe. Need to find the Arch of Malugi, or Malugi, however it's pronounced.
Turn around when it is safe to do so. Recalculating route. In 400 meters, turn right.
Cool. I wonder if that one will count. Forza edition of it. I don't want to take the chance. I have a chain for this. Nope. Good old you Grundy, and you Grundy we trust. A good test is the all right, so the trial is this. Ugh, another no upgrades thing. That's so stupid. Just hope this stream takes and it's still there so I can export it. I've tried to stream this a few times and it hasn't taken hold in my history for people to watch later, let alone for me to export.
Thank you.
good tune. Push it a lot harder than what I am doing. I'm just not used to being able to push that hard, especially in those corners. Well, considering some of them did faster laps than me, that's crazy. Although they were slipstreaming, especially those guys at the back, they would have had the benefit of slipstream for the whole race. Alright. Here's your challenge complete. There it is. That doubles the ForzaThon points to 200. The Ram Power Wagon is a great car. It's like meta. And I think that's going to be a wrap. I do the event lab. Rally Monster S1. I've surely got a Rally Monster S1. I don't need to go and check. I do, however, click on that because it will just take me to where it is. You're kidding. Oh my god, it's going to be a long race. I don't have any of these on my favorites. I don't know how those will handle, but I did do those. What I should do is swap into that 911 GT3 RS, find a tune for it, even though it's already at S1, but there'll be a tune that makes it handle better. One for road, one for dirt, and I have a feeling this event's road. That's better all around. I'll just go this. Might as well find a livery for it too. Really, that's high up there. That's meant to be the 918 spider. Why not? Just hop into any old car, just so I can look at the stats side by side of the Hoonigan one when I go back to do it. Right. 7471101078882. Better in every regard for that. Just more torque, less horsepower though, heavier. Somehow more torque with less horsepower, even despite the lower displacement engine. The grip on this thing. So close to being perfect. I'm not even really looking at where I'm driving. I'm mostly looking at the map in my bottom left corner so I can kind of prepare mentally what I need to do next. thought I was going to slide into that. Most of the time I don't like the event layout tracks, but this one's good. That's going to conclude the stream, everyone. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Found it helpful. If you did, you know what to do. Hit that follow button so you get notified when I go live next with whatever I go live next with. I'll also be exporting this to my YouTube channel, so if you're interested in checking that out, follow the link underneath the live stream panel as well as in the description. I upload all my clips and stuff to there, so that's one of the good things about that, because I can't upload them to Twitch for some reason. So yeah, if you guys happen to mosey on over there and like what you see, then why not help me out and subscribe? It means a hell of a lot to me, and I'd very much appreciate it. Likewise, if you're on my YouTube channel or want to find my Twitch, where I do my live stuff, follow the link in the description as well as in the channel banner. Drop a comment and stuff you guys like to see me do next, or things you think I could do better with, or just to pop in and say hey. And I hope you're having a great day or great night wherever you are. And I just hope that this actually takes and saves the stream, like it, because it hasn't done that the last few times. Despite it saying in the where my little stream overlay panel is, saying I'm live. But hopefully, because it does say there's someone watching, that that means it's actually running correctly, and that it will take and save, so I can export this. Just a little double check to make sure I've done everything that I can do, that I'm wanting to do, and yep. Alright. Catch you in the next one, everyone.